God. So we're going to talk about it. It had to be more than just a ride on a donkey, Pastor. It had to be more than a ride or a cruise into Jerusalem. No, no, no. Let's take a look at what happens when Jesus comes along and see. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Nelly, I remember several years ago that you had a little bout with a little disease.
All right.
You told us all in the church. You prayed, we prayed, and what happened? Along came Jesus. Healing power came on the scene. I know some got some more witnesses in here. You don't have a cold before. Do you know that when people used to get the hiccups, they used to die? My God, my God. We got two doctors in here that I know of. We have hundreds of thousands of diseases out there that can attack your body at any time. Don't wait until you get a problem to start saying Jesus. Have Jesus in your back pocket already.
All right.
I like to say it like this. I used to hear Pastor Glenn say this. He said, I would rather have them and not need them than need them and not have them. Amen. Praise God. And so we're going to look back. We're going to look back over your life, my life, and look back on some witnesses.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. First one here. Long came Jesus to give us life and give it more abundantly. The Lord told me to start out with this because a lot of people don't understand this. So I talked about it already. King James says this, a thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and destroy. That's a colon right up there, right? There's no period there, Nelly. There's a colon. Whatever's on the other side of the colon is magnified. Jesus says, what? I am come. Along came Jesus. I am come. That they, Sister Pam West, who are they he's talking about?
Talking about us.
Who is us?
People.
People, what type of people?
God's people.
How do you become God's people?
Believers.
Come on now.
Believers.
Yeah, let's make it, we got business today.
Right.
Believers, he says, I have come that the believers might have life.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder why he said might, Pastor. Because some of us, we think we're doing this thing ourselves. Some of us wake up in the morning and say, oh, the alarm clock woke me up. Well, I'll tell you what, let's go out the forest lawn and set up a bunch of alarm clocks and see how many folks get up. The Lord woke you up this morning. Hallelujah. Lord, that's why I wake up every morning. Ready for prayer force one at 6:30. I said, I woke up this morning with my mind staying on Jesus. Now, why do I say that? Because if my mind wasn't on Jesus, I wouldn't even know how to dial that number to get on prayer for us. What a mighty God we serve. I like this part. He said, not only do they have life, but that they might have it more abundantly. Now, Dr. Lori, abundantly is a lot.
Yeah.
Right? Everybody agree with me? Abundance is a lot.
Yeah.
But he says more abundantly. Woo! That's why I said along came Jesus in my life.
Yeah.
But look at the New Living Translation. There's a little bit of twist on it, Pastor. It says that the thief's purpose is to steal, kill, and destroy. The devil's purpose in life is to kill you, kill your children, destroy your dreams, steal everything that you have. That's his purpose. And the sooner you and I understand that, the sooner we can have this life that Jesus is talking about. But look at the next part. My purpose, Jesus said. That's why I said, along came Jesus. My purpose is to give them, Sister Pam, say the believers, a rich and satisfied life. That's what more abundantly means. Hallelujah. We ought not be living check to check. Why? Because along came Jesus, Palmer. We ought not be having problems with all. Oh, I can't. If the car gets messed up, you can got the money to get it fixed. Praise the Lord. I thank God for the money to go to the repair shop. If the TV go off, listen, I paid for the warranty. If I didn't, the Lord blessed me that we can take care. That's called more abundantly.
Yes.
Praise God. Children want to go to college? You got more abundantly that you can go and send them to college. Many of us, we don't even think about that. We don't even think about that. Lay on in, make them baby, you don't even take care of them. I charge you, Lewis and Vanessa, today. Get this thing together. That baby's gonna go to college. She's gonna get a full ride scholarship.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. That's what we're talking about. Over here, we believe in full ride scholarship.
Right.
Jace, you gonna get a, what's your name?
Jace.
You gonna get a full ride scholarship to school. Come on. That's to college. Right. It might be a track, and it might be an academics.
Yeah.
Anybody who blessed me, you're going to be satisfied. That's called a bundle of life. Why? Because along came Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. We're going to move right along here. He came to seek the lost, Pastor, according to Luke 19 and 10. For the Son of Man has come to seek to save that which was lost.
Mm-hmm.
That is us.
Yeah.
He came to save the lost.
Mm-hmm.
Next one. He came to serve. Mm-hmm. Now, he's the senior pastor. I'm the executive pastor. But when y'all came in today, did y'all see him at the front door?
Yeah.
Yeah. He a servant. I don't need him coming, sitting in the back room somewhere, waiting till all y'all are here. He come out of me and everybody standing like, God just came on the scene.
Okay.
The devil is alive. We're servants. We serve here. We serve tables. He and I come. We watch this and do that. And I don't care when the ministry grow. We still don't serve. Y'all have to catch me in here asking y'all to serve me. I'm out.
Okay.
No, I don't want you to serve me. We serve the people. We meet the needs of the people. This church was made to meet the needs of the people.
Right.
Praise God. For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve. And if Jesus can serve, we have to serve.
Right.
How many titles you got?
Amen.
You got two doctors in here, two of the greatest servants I know. They don't care about all that. Their mama put them through school and they made it, but they're still servants. Because they understand that had not been for the Lord on their side, they would have become doctors. Praise the Lord. Along came Jesus. What else did he come to do? Come to take away sin. Now once at the consummation of the ages, he has been manifested to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. That's the type of God that we serve. He sacrificed his own self. God realized couldn't nobody reconcile man back to himself but himself. So he wrapped himself, Pastor, in flesh and came down 42 generations. Hallelujah. Through a virgin birth. Hallelujah. To a woman down in Nazareth. And people say, well, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Yeah. Along came Jesus. My Savior came out of Nathan. Hallelujah. That's when Nathaniel got smart and said that. But I come to tell you, Jesus, hallelujah, he ain't poor. He never was poor.
Right.
He's seated at the right hand of God, now intercessing for you and for me.
Thank
hallelujah.
You,
next verse, John 3 and 5 said, you know that he appeared to do what? In order to take away sins. Visitors. All of my people here, they already know this. Don't let sin block you or stop you from seeing God's face. Many people don't go to church because when I'm sin and I'm dirty and I'm not worthy. That's when Jesus wants you to come.
Yes.
1 John 1 and 9 said, confess that sin.
Yes.
And God is faithful and just to forgive you and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. God will give you a shower and won't even remember it no more.
Yes.
Don't let sin defeat you. Jesus already has come to take it away.
Yes.
It's already defeated. Praise God. You're out here worried about, well, I messed up, I said the wrong thing. Listen, you can't help but to sin. Let me tell you what, Moses said if you committed the act, it was sin. But Jesus said if you thought the act, it's sin. So who in here been riding down the street and somebody cut you off on the street? Cut you off and praise God. I got a professional here. He told me, stay in front of the podium, okay? All right, like, praise God. Yeah. I mean, you know, it's all about God. It's all about God. All right, real quickly. Next one is doing what? Along came Jesus to change water into wine. Before Jesus began his public ministry, he performed a miracle of changing water into wine at a wedding banquet in the village of Cana of Galilee, which is the region in the land of Israel. Jesus' mother, Mary, and his disciples were guests at the wedding. The supply of wine ran out, and through the urging of his mother. Now, anybody here ever wear Nike gym shoes? You know, what's the tag for Nike? Just what? They stole that from this verse. Yep, because Jesus' mother told the servant, whatever he says, do it. I'm saying to you today, whatever the book says, do it. You can't go wrong if you follow the book. Look what happened. It says here, the supply of wine ran out, and through the urging of his mother, saw that Jesus had six water pots filled to the brim with water. And the water was miraculously turned into wine. That was Jesus' first miracle. Again, along came Jesus. You ought not have a wedding if you didn't invite Jesus. I'm going to say that again. Praise the Lord. You ought not have, listen, before we go over there and break bread, we're going to take Jesus with us. Amen? I ain't going nowhere. I don't care if the ship is on a plane or a spaceship. I ain't going nowhere. Jesus got to go with me. He lives in me. His spirit dwells in me. Hebrews 8:11 says this. The same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwells in us. What does that mean? Hallelujah. That means you and I got resurrection power on the inside. Praise God. Listen, if I didn't have no money in my pocket, I got a few tens and twenties in here. Jesus has the power and has given it to me to resurrect my dead bank account. Yeah. Praise the Lord. If he can raise Lazarus from the dead, he said, Lazarus, come forth. He can show us safe. Chase and TCF and all these banks, you better get right by myself. Hallelujah. Praise his name. I give too much not to get that upon me. Hallelujah. Yeah, I'm just telling you like it is. Along came Jesus. He healed the royal official's son in John 4:46, a royal official. We have six sons in Capernaum. Yeah, listen to this. He heard that Jesus had traveled to the town of Cana. The official went to Cana and begged Jesus to go to Capernaum to heal his son who was about to die. Get this, y'all need to hear this. Jesus told the man that his son would live. The man believed Jesus and left Cana. Now hear what happened now. He heard that Jesus was in town. Along came Jesus. He went over and talked to Jesus and said, Jesus, I believe that you have the power to heal my son. See, y'all need to say that sometimes. I don't care what you're going on in your house. I believe that you could really open up these windows and pour me out a blessing. I should have room enough to receive it. You know, Jesus, your word says in Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. Use the word of God when you pray. This man, look what happened. It says here, the man believed Jesus and left. While the man was returning to Capernaum, get this, his servants met him on the way and told him that his son was alive and that the son's fever had gone away at 1 p.m. Now, what's so significant, Chip, about the 1 p.m.? It was the same time that Jesus... Woo! The man realized that that was the same time that Jesus told him that your son would live.
All right.
I don't have time to talk about it today, but in Daniel chapter 10, read that sometime. Daniel prayed 21 days, Nelly, waiting for the Lord to come. And he got held up, and he just waited. All of a sudden, the angel came to him and said, Daniel, y'all ready for this? From the first day you started praying, the Lord dispatched me on your way. Along came Jesus. That's not a word about nothing.
Yes,
open up your mouth and say so. The Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so.
Yes,
hallelujah. He woke me up this morning. He started me on my way. God is a good God. From the first day, Daniel, you started praying. The Lord dispatched me to help you. But I got held up. The king of Prussia got in a fight with Satan. But I'm here now.
Thank you.
Pastor just said like this, look at me now. Jesus is here.
Yes,
hallelujah. God. Praise God. Hallelujah. What's the next one here? I'm almost finished. We're going to go back to the triumphant entry. Healing Peter's mother-in-law. Is that what that was saying?
Right. Okay.
Amen.